If you're a 90s desi kid who grew up on a healthy appetite of Bollywood, then I'm pretty sure you vaguely remember the film Dil Bole Hadappa. This film is about a person whose only ambition in life is to make it big as a cricketer. The only problem, she's a woman. And women don't play cricket, as she's being told on multiple occasions throughout the film. So her solution, she dresses up as a man to get in with one of the biggest cricket teams in the country. And that's how she's able to fulfill her ambitions. And that, in a nutshell, is the main conflict, the conflict resolution, and the general plot of every mainstream Bollywood film that has a sportswoman as its protagonist. Think of Milkha Singh's character in the film Bhaag Milkha Bhaag. The protagonist of the film was a wholesome, real and relatable character. He had personal struggles, he had hurdles to overcome, and he had romantic relationships without the film placing any judgment on it. But most importantly, he was given the space to make mistakes and falter without that actually affecting his career as a sportsperson. But think of Preeti Sabharwal, Komal Chautala, or Vidya Sharma in the film Chakde India. Preeti's personal life was heavily dependent on her win and success as a hockey player. If it weren't for her big finish, she would probably have been coerced into getting married. Or Vidya, who was in her own ride or die situation with her family and her husband and her in-laws. Not winning for her would have probably meant having to give up her career entirely. All these characters needed to prove their capabilities beyond just the normal hustle that's required for any normal sportsperson. Remember towards the end of the film when they're all returning home and Komal Chautala's father expresses pride for her by saying this.
Baba, agar tujhe khelne se roko, to isi aankhe se do dard diyo mujhe.
Na baapu.
Na dard de na. Aur kisi ka baap agar usse roke na, to usse bhi dard de.
This shows that when Komal did make that win, she lifted the bias for her whole community. Sportswomen, or even women in general, are pressured to take the hit for all women. But think about this. What do you think would have happened if Komal Chautala didn't make that big win? Do you think her father would have then let her play hockey again? But what about when Milkha Singh lost that race because he was a little bit distracted with Stella, his love interest? So food for thought. Do you think Komal, Preeti or Vidya would have been given the space to bounce back into their game after they lost a match like that? And that's how it works for films with sportswomen as protagonists, right? They have two things to prove. Not just that they're good at the sport, but that they deserve to be there despite their gender. Let's talk about Saan Ki Aankh.
वैसे आपकी उम्र क्या होगी?
लगभग 60 के ऊपर नहीं तो होगी.
A very dominant subplot of the film is all that peripheral extra effort that Prakashi and Chandru have to take in order to sustain their shooting careers. Hiding away from their husbands, India being the object of scrutiny and ridicule at every competition they go to, etc, etc. The same added effort was also a major subplot of the films Mary Kom and Panga. Despite living in a supportive domestic environment, both Jaya and Mary Kom's journey was infested with numerous moments of skepticism, stemming purely from the need for them to essay multiple roles at once. The mother, the wife, the player. A male sportsperson's struggle to balance home and sports is never an issue somehow. What does that tell us about the society we live in? But take Dangal for example. Sure, their father faced a lot of flak from the people around him when he proudly declares this.
Mari choriyan choron se kam hai ke.
But that's all the flak that there was. For protagonists Geeta and Babita, the plot almost entirely focuses on their wrestling journey. Their struggles, their challenges, their growth. The plot didn't particularly bother them with the imposition of a family or motherhood. So it's not like it's completely in the realm of impossibility to imagine women as wholesome sports players, for whom marriage and kids, or the lack of them, is not the deciding make or break factor, just like it isn't for men. And of course, films reflect the society we live in. So it's a question of what will change first, real situations or our portrayals of them, or maybe both, as each impacts the other. So this National Sports Day, as we celebrate the spirit of sports, let's not forget the struggles that sportswomen have to face. Where are those struggles really coming from? Is it from the sport itself, or from being able to play the sport in the first place?